Hello, it's Nitro99 again, and I'll be doing a review on the complete Series 1 of LEGO's collectible minifigures. They cost $2 a piece, and they come in a random bag. But the whole one minifigure is in the bag, so you get the entire minifigure. And this is what the bag looks like. It's hard to open with your hands, so you have to cut them with a scissor. And also, I want to make note that the components are made in China. And LEGO's using Chinese plastic, so the plastic is a little cheaper, and there's also a chance that the minifigures may be warped or damaged. A person pointed that out to me on a skateboarder. The whole back torso was warped and messed up. So Chinese plastic is cheaper, but at the same time, these minifigures are still really cool. So this is the little booklet. Comes with all the little packages. Back, it basically shows how to put the accessories on the figure, and shows all 16, which I have all 16. And onto the minifigures. I'm gonna review them in the order that I opened them. I just opened them random, but the first one I opened was Robin Hood guy. His little goatee, torso, a bow and arrow, a quiver. None of these minifigures have back printing, to let you know. Some of them have leg printing, this one does not. That little Robin Hood hat and a little plume. He comes with an extra plume. Some of the figures have extra pieces, some don't. And torso, I think the torso is new, the face is new. So that's about it for him. He's a neat figure. The next one I opened was the Indian, Native American. I don't know if it's a girl or a boy, but he has leg printing, a new torso, no back printing, a quiver, a hairpiece, which I don't believe is new, it was in the old Indian sets, two feathers, and a bow and arrow, and you get an extra piece of these two feathers. They're black on the top there. Next one I opened was the Magician. You know, one of those performance magicians like Chris Angel. He uses one of these wands for show, and he has a top hat, new face, torso. Nothing too special about him. He comes with an actual hairpiece, which I'll show you what he looks like with the hairpiece on. He looks pretty good, but that's nice they included that. The fourth minifigure I opened was the cowboy. New face, Indiana Jones hat, and light tan. He comes with three guns. Brown pants, which are kind of lame. The torso is really nice, and his face is nice. So, he's a cool, pretty cool figure. He's one of the ones I really wanted. But, of course, I got them all, so I get everyone, but the fifth guy I opened was the new astronaut. This minifigure seems to be very popular among some of the collectors. He has new legs, new torso, a new ray gun, lightsaber piece, but it is smaller than the regular lightsabers. Please take note. And Space Police helmet, it's white. It's a new face. And he's a pretty cool figure, not my favorite, by no means, but... Oh, and I forgot to mention, all the minifigures have these little black plates, so you stand them on. So, yeah, everyone has that. And also, the astronaut has another visor, which is... no one cares about visors. The sixth minifigure, this is probably my favorite, and the one I wanted the most, is the skateboarder. New torso with a skull. Yeah, I really like that torso. Pants are just dark blue. Skateboard is just blue, but I really think if LEGO is going to make these collectible minifigures, they should have made like a skateboard with like skulls and flames on it. That would have been nice. New face, new hair. I really like the hair as well. It's not Anakin Skywalker's hair. It's a new design. And it's a pretty cool figure. Comes with a plate. Next is the ninja. He's kind of plain. I mean, the torso, I think it's the same as Luke Skywalker's, when he uses the black torso. Ninja hood is the same. Gold katanas, same. Only thing new about him is the face. He has a nice face. But he's kind of a bland minifigure. Not much collectible there. Next is the robot. A very cool figure. New legs. New torso. New helmet. The arm has been done before in agent sets, but even still, he looks like a robot. And he also has a face. It's kind of hard to pick that up. It's so shiny. But it is like a robotic face. It's cool if you want to make a movie like Attack of the Robots or something. And then, of course, you could also make a movie Attack of the Zombies, which I'll get to in a minute. And the robot comes with an extra hand. So that's nice. Another boring figure is the diver. There's nothing special about him, really. I mean, he has a new uniform. Flippers and tank. And he has a new face. But he's not that special. His face is kind of, it's kind of sad looking. I think he's kind of, he pities himself because he's the lamest figure of the bunch. But, kind of ironic. And next is the cheerleader. A very cool figure. I want more than one of these because if you just switch around the head and the hair, you can have different cheerleaders. The pom-poms are very nice. They hook in. There's this little hook, you know, clipping there, you know, the hands clip onto. The hair is in blonde. That's a new, I mean, it's not a new hairpiece, but now it's in blonde. Face is nice. No idea what the M means. And she has a skirt printing on the legs. So it's a nice figure. Next is the zombie, which I think everyone wants. And I want more than one of. I mean, he's a zombie. What more is there to say? He comes with a shovel, which is strange, and a piece of meat, which makes sense because he wants to eat. But, man, the zombie looks cool. So, yeah. Next, there is the clown. Not much to say about the clown. He's cool, but there's not enough to make a Killer Clowns movie. I mean, he's just kind of the same. So you need to get kind of different torsos to make more clowns. The horn is new, but it's kind of cheap feeling. And the afro is red. But you could paint that black, make a real afro. He's a cool figure, though. I like him. Next is the nurse. Which, I mean, you could put her head and hair on the cheerleader and have a different cheerleader. That's what I thought. She has a printed piece that has, like, some kind of, you know, chart for health and says Dawes on it. I don't know what that means. A nurse uniform, new face, two syringes. Get two of these things. So that's pretty cool. Previously, Brick Arms made a syringe, and I have one of those, but these are different. Next, you have the Crash Test Dummy, which is a pretty common figure I've heard from this minifigure wave. So it's pretty easy to get this guy. And he has a license plate, which you could use for custom cars, and he has a wrench. Not much you could use this guy for. Maybe for atom bomb testing. But, yeah. Next is the caveman. He's okay, but it's not that special. His club is not the same as the trolls and the castle sets. And he has, like, I think it was Hagrid's hair. I don't have Hagrid, so I don't know, but that kind of beard. And this is his face. And this is the beard. Pretty cool. Finally, I have the wrestler. And not a lot of people actually like this guy because you can't do much of him, but I like him. He could be a superhero for one thing, and he's also a wrestler. But, yeah. That's it. So, there you see my pile of minifigures. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and see you later. Hope you enjoyed this.